guys. So today I wanted to do a Birchbox review for you guys. I just got my new January Birchbox about a week and a half ago, and I've already tried out some of the stuff, so I already kind of have, you know, dislikes and likes about everything, and I'm really excited to share that with you guys because I've been getting Birchboxes for a while now, but I've never done a Birchbox video because I kind of wanted to start for the new year and I didn't want to kind of start randomly. So anyway, if you guys don't know what Birchbox is, basically they send you a Birchbox, which is this awesome box here, and it has a bunch of different sort of samples of different products in it, and when you get them, you just sort of try them out, and if you like them, then you can buy them. So for further explanations on Birchboxes, there's tons of videos out there on YouTube, and I know tons of people will probably do this particular Birchbox video, but anyway, I wanted to do one of my own because I'm going to start doing them for every month in 2012. So let's get started. The first thing that I got in my Birchbox, when I opened it up, the first thing that I saw was the Origins Checks and Balances Frothy Face Wash. Let's see if this will focus for you guys. I've actually already used this product before I got it in my Birchbox. This is mine. It's all old and gross, and I've used quite a bit of it. I really like this cleanser. It's not my definite favorite, but I went through a stage in my life where I was obsessed with Origins. This was one of my favorite products that they had, actually, and the reason I like it is because it lathers up so well. So I would say that this would be good to use with like a Clarisonic or any of those you know, electronic face cleansing things. I personally just use this little brush with mine, and it just lathers so amazingly, and you don't need a lot at all. It just lathers up really well, and you know, it's a frothy face wash, so it does get quite frothy. Here's my new one just to show you guys, because they didn't give me, this is like the sample size, and this is compared to my size, so there really wasn't that much of a size difference, really. This one, the one that I got, is 1.7 fluid ounces, and this one's 1 fluid ounce. So yeah, they're about the same. When you buy it, you know, I think there's a bigger one that you can get, but anyway, I really like that product. And so since I had already tried it out, I kind of already had a lot of nice things to say about it. The next thing that I found in my Birchbox when I opened it up was the Juicy Couture sample of, this is Juicy Couture. Juicy Couture. It's their signature fragrance. That's what it's called, is Juicy Couture. And this is perfect. It says perfect for day or night. And I really love this scent. It's not my favorite juicy scent, unfortunately. But it is one of my favorites. And I really love juicy scents. But this one I feel like is a little too, I don't know, I don't want to say strong, and I don't want to say alcohol-y smelling, but it kind of smells like, I don't know, like alcohol. It says it has a blend of floral notes, and I definitely smell floral, but there's something else to it. Yeah, I'm not really great at describing scents, but if you guys stop by Sephora or Ulta, you guys can definitely check this out and smell it for yourself. I'll definitely use this just because I have it, but I wouldn't probably go out and buy it because it's, you know, like I said, it's not my favorite. Another thing that I got in my Birchbox this month was the Archipelago. I probably completely killed that name. I think it's Archipelago. And this is the pomegranate body soap. I have not used this, and the reason for that is because I have so many soaps from Lush that are like this, you know, hard soaps like this from Lush, and I just don't really need another soap. I literally bought so many, but it is very pretty. I don't know if you guys can see the design on that, but it's a really pretty like design on the front of the soap, and then on the back it says the Archipelago, however you say that. I think I'm actually gonna add this in with my giveaway, because I think that it's cute box and it'll go well with all the giveaway stuff, and the more like small stuff that I can find that I can stick in that little giveaway bag, the more stuff that I can fit in there, the more I'm gonna give you guys, because I just like adding to it. I know at first it kind of seemed like not that much stuff, but I've got a ways to go to get 150 subscribers, so I've got plenty of time to add more stuff to it. And I feel like every time I see something small and cute that I would want for myself, I'm gonna add it. So this is going in the giveaway, and it's pomegranate scented. It's triple milled. I don't really know the terms for soap, but apparently that's awesome. And it's from, it says, from the branch to the body, a natural antioxidant to refresh, soothe, and protect. So this is probably a really great soap. I wouldn't know, I haven't used it yet, but if you get this in the giveaway, you guys can let me know, or if you get Birchboxes, to let me know if you like this stuff. I also got a magnet this month in my Birchbox that's just the Birchbox design, which is kind of cool, just a freebie kind of thing. And they also gave us the Lara Bar. I don't know if that's how I say it, but this is the carrot cake one. I don't really like carrot cake. I'm not a big fan of carrot cake, and I really do like granola bars and fruit and nut bars a lot. I love Luna bars and stuff, but I'm probably gonna give this to someone because I don't particularly like carrot cake, and I don't think I'm gonna like it, and I don't wanna waste it and eat it and, you know, hate it. So anyway, my favorite thing, this is the last thing that was in my Birchbox, but it's definitely been my favorite thing. This is the Stella Smudge Stick Waterproof Eyeliner, and this is amazing. I had wanted to try a Stella eyeliner before because I had seen some really great reviews on them, but I just hadn't really gotten the chance to actually get one. Mine came in the color Baguette, I think that's what it is. Oh no, I'm sorry. It's Lionfish, actually. It just says Baguette. Anyway, I'm not reading this right. But anyway, this is Lionfish. This is a really pretty brown. I will swatch it for you. This goes on so easily. And I would definitely say even easier than the 24/7 liner from Urban Decay. And also, I would say that they're more pigmented than the 24/7 liners from Urban Decay. I have a problem with the 24/7 liners sometimes, where they look really great on the outer corner of my eye, but in the inner corner, it's kind of like lighter. And these, I have no problem with at all. And this brown is really, really pretty for my eye color and my hair color, because I know blondes are supposed to wear more browns, but I'm definitely a black liner girl. But I will probably use this for other things. I might just go buy the black liner in this one just because I like it so much. And it works really good on the waterline too. I know that Stila has one that's waterproof, and this is the waterproof. And I'm excited about this because in a month I'm going to spring break in the Bahamas, and I don't really have that many waterproof things, so I will definitely be bringing this to the Bahamas and wearing this probably all the time. But anyway, that was all of the products. If you guys have any questions or comments, leave them below. And don't forget to subscribe if you like my videos. Thank you guys so much for watching, and have a nice day.